Really,
people that say the hair transplant don't hurt, they lie, or they get paid from the company, because that's bullshit, man. That's bullshit. That was the worst day of my life, and the worst 3 days after, the worst pain wow. I've ever felt in my life. I would never ever go for another.
Guys, you've gotta watch this one to the very end. I had a conversation with my man Francesco, who opens up about his story with hair loss and the different routes that he's taken, from hair systems to hair transplants and all sorts of different things. It's not only informational, it's very, very funny hearing him describe what having a hair transplant is like. And he's got great, great nuggets throughout the entire thing. So make sure you like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell below, so that way other people get to see this content as well. And let's jump into the video. Welcome back, everybody. Today we have Francesco. He's over in Italy right now. Francesco has had a really interesting story when it comes to hair loss and the decisions he's made. He's got a lot of advice, a lot of nuggets for those of you at home that are going through this journey with us. But let's jump into the video. Francesco, how is it going, man?
Yeah, great, man. Thanks for having me, Jake. It's really nice to be here today. And thanks again for the opportunity.
Yeah, man, anytime. I'm really excited to talk with you and get to... So a little teaser for those that are watching here online right now. Francesco, you have gone through a couple different strategies of dealing with your hair loss. Can you just briefly say like the things that you've gone through, and then I'm going to take us back through your story with hair loss.
Right. Yeah. So okay, everything goes back to 2016. It was February when I actually decided to have my first hair system.
So you've done a hair system.
Yeah.
And then.
And then a hair transplant.
And then a hair transplant. Okay, cool. So you've pretty much been going all over the...
I've pretty much been through everything.
I love it. Well, cool. Yeah. So let's go back. Let's start, at the beginning of, your hair loss and where all of that story begins.
Uh-huh. Okay, so let's start with the thing that I'm a barber for a start. So I'm a hairdresser. I cut men for a living. So I always been kind of obsessed with hair. Mm. So let's say that, because it's always been my job anyway. When I started to notice that I was losing my hair, that had a huge impact on my confidence.
Yeah. How old were you?
I was 24 when I started noticing major hair loss, and I'm 32 now. So it's been over 8 years now. Wow. Mm-hmm. That I've been dealing with hair losses in total. And I remember at the time, that was a really, really hard time for me, because I used to spend more time looking at myself in the mirror, like styling my hair, blow drying, and using lots of products in my hair. And when I started noticing that my hair was getting thinner and thinner and thinner, and I was literally left with so much hair in my hands every day. Every single day I would find so many hair in my hands. And I was like, oh my God, man, this is just isn't work. Because I couldn't style my hair anymore the way I used to do it. Because I just didn't have enough hair to do it anymore. Because I was receding just so badly. So I started to do lots of researches online. And after a few months, I came across a company that's called Total Cover Plus, as a company based in London. They basically they made these hair systems, and they are associated with so many salons based across UK.
Sure.
So you can basically just book yourself online, choose the salon new to you, you just go there, and you for a set price, they do everything. They install the system, they give you a haircut, consultation and everything. I was really nervous before I took this decision, because like you say in your videos, it's still like a taboo topic about what when we come to hair systems, and because so many people still see it as a wig, like so many people still see it as like if you're wearing a wig, which is not, because the technology now is so advanced that
it's not even recognizable. It's a toupee, exactly. But it's really not. I mean, it's completely customized.
Exactly. And it's not like it used to be 50 years ago. This is what many people don't know. It's actually made of real hair. Like 90% is made of real hair. So, but anyway, so I decided to try to give it a go to this company. So one day I called a friend of mine. I said, I need you to come with me because I can't do this thing by myself. I need a little bit of support. So I explained the situation to this guy, and I talked to, he's one of my best friends anyway. I sat down with him and explained what my plan was. I said, look, I'm going to go to this company and get this hair system done and see how it goes. So I remember I went to this salon in London, and it was February. So the moment I walked in, I spoke to the guy, and I had already an appointment with him. So we had a little chat, and he asked me what my expectations were about, like what kind of style I wanted, and blah blah blah, and all of this. So we just did it. We just done it. And after about 50 minutes, I had a massive head of hair on my head, and I was completely, the result was just outstanding. I couldn't stop touching hair, because for me, I just couldn't believe it. I was so happy. I left that place. I literally, before he finished the job, I said to him, can I book for my next appointment already? I was so excited. I couldn't believe it. I started sending pictures to all my friends, my mom, my dad, to everyone. And I was just so happy. And that was, I remember that for me has been life-changing day. Since that day, I was another person. I was going out again, I was going clubbing, I was going to the gym again, I was hanging out with, that changed my life. That was
Let me interrupt you real quick. Can you define what it was that changed inside of you? You said it was a life-changing moment.
It was life-changing because...
What was it inside that changed?
Inside me, I regained straight away my confidence, because every day I was looking myself in the mirror and I thought, oh, I just don't like myself. I just don't like the way I look. I just didn't like the way I looked, because I thought that hair on the man, that really, really important, because they frame your face. So if you don't have hair, I mean, some people that can pull it off, they look good with a buzz cut, but some people just don't. And I'm sorry, but you need hair, because hair is really, really, really important. And straight away, when this guy, he made this hair system, it's just everything changed. For me, I looked like another, I looked different, I looked better, I felt better. I just gained confidence straight away.
Yeah. And so, I mean, that's a great story. And I think a lot of people agree with you about hair. Could you briefly tell me, what is it like? You're Italian, correct?
Yeah, I'm Italian, yeah.
Yeah, so what's the culture when it comes to hair in the Italian culture? Is there any significance to it?
I think people in Italy, I mean, where I come from, I come from South Italy, I come from Napoli.
Okay.
The mentality is very different from South Italy and North Italy. In South Italy, people are... they really love themselves. They care about how they look, about the hair, about how they dress. They're very obsessed with this. In Napoli, actually, we do have a couple of places that they install hair systems. That explains the fact that in Napoli we actually really are obsessed with hair and with the appearance in general. So.
You heard it here first, everybody. Italians, specifically Southern Italians, are obsessed with themselves and they love themselves.
Definitely.
So, no, that's all good, man. Yeah. So, okay. So basically, you went to go, you get a hair system, you fall in love with it. What happened over the next couple of years?
So I had it for the next 4 years until the very last month before I had my transplant, until I had to take it off because the surgeon.
Sure.
Actually advised me to, because I was using the glue, the super bond, the Gauss bond, and he said to me, if you use glue, it's better that if you just take it off, let your scalp breathe and let your hair grow as much as you can, because we need to see what your hair is like. Even if it's thin, doesn't matter, we need to see what your hair is like to give you a better consultation. I had it for, like I said, for the next 4 years, and I never ever had a single problem with it. I mean, the leagues, yeah, I used to play Sunday leagues, I used to go to the gym, so I used to do pretty much a lot of activities like you do, like CrossFit classes and things like this. Now the thing is, I was lucky in a way, because like I said, being a barber for me, that has been major help, because I was constantly in front of a mirror and I always had stuff in my shop, like glue. I had my boss who is actually a barber, so if I ever needed to re-glue it, to rebond it, I could do it straight away, immediately, because I had a salon. I used to work in a salon every day, and that was a major, and this was major help, like for someone who's actually wearing a hair system. Like yeah. I said, I never had any issue with it apart from like these little things, like when I, because I used to do spear fishing as well over the summer when I used to go on holiday, I used to do spear fishing. But since I had the hair system, I stopped this because I've had a couple of little problems with this. Like when I used to go, like I used to dive like really deep, and I was sweating because I was sunbathing on the boat as well, and I couldn't carry like my glue with me all the time, and I couldn't even do it. Like even if I wanted to, I couldn't do it. So yeah. One day I remember I went to do spear fishing, and my system like lifted up like almost up to the middle of my head, and I was like, Jesus, I can't do this, because I said, what if I do another attempt, then I'm gonna lose my system in the middle of the sea, and then that's it, it's gone. So I was like, Jesus, I can't do this. And I think that put a little seed in my head. Like in a way, I loved it, and I used to enjoy it a lot. But then a hair transplant has always been in the back of my head. Like another thing that's made me really conscious about it. This is another important aspect. I mean, to me, it was. Like, if I ever was to go out with a girl, like I never told, like my ex-girlfriend knew about it, but if I had to date a girl, I wouldn't tell her. I mean, I never actually said that to anyone. And if they tried like to put like their heads, like to rub my head or touch, I was like, oh no. I was like, that made me really conscious about it, because I always thought, oh, what if I'm sweating, maybe they touch my hair and the system lifts it up a little bit. That always gave me a little bit of, I don't know if you know what I'm trying to say.
Yeah. Yeah, anxiety.
Yeah, a little bit of anxiety, exactly. Yes, I was never really comfortable like wearing it if I was going out with a girl, let's say that. Made me a little bit paranoid about it.
Yeah. Yeah, so it sounds like that and the clash with your lifestyle, spearfishing, really kind of changed the gear in your mind.
Exactly.
And I think it's really important, just kind of taking a quick note to the side here, that if anybody is considering a hair system, like, it, not saying that you didn't have the right hair system, the right glue or adhesive, or you did anything wrong, but if you're going to get a hair system, you have to find one, you have to find the right combination of solutions that matches your lifestyle.
Exactly.
And you do have to stay on top of it. So, you know, could you go spearfishing like the day after you rebonded your hair system and probably have absolutely no worries? Probably, right?
Probably, yeah.
Do it on day 10? Yeah. Probably not the best idea, right? So there are definitely considerations and things that you kind of have to strategize about if you're wearing a hair system, along with getting the right hair system, right glue. But anyways, getting back into your story, so you know, you have this shift in your mind, and you always had the hair transplant in the back of your head, and you're thinking about it, which leads you to today. You said a couple months ago that you had a hair transplant, right?
Yeah, I did. I went to Turkey on August 16th, and I had my operation on August 31st. I actually been there for 2 weeks because I wanted a kind of like a little break before I came back to Italy. So I took the opportunity just to like visit the city, exploring around before I actually had my operation, because as you know, once you have your operation, that's it. You just can't do anything. You can't go around in the sun. You can't work out. You can't do nothing.
Yeah.
So yeah. I chose this clinic after about 6 months I've been researching online, and I found two clinics that actually really impressed me, like for the content that they were uploading and showing the pictures, the qualities and everything. It was the one that I end up going, which is Hair of Istanbul. And there was another one called Cosmedica. So one has got like over a million followers on Instagram. They're really popular. They had a couple of celebrities from TV shows in England going in there, and they start like bumping up their prices as well. Another one was a little bit cheaper, but the reason why I didn't go there is because they, when I text them on WhatsApp, they actually told me that I needed the two procedures instead of one, where Hair of Istanbul actually said, we're gonna try to do everything in one session. You know, we tell you now, it's gonna be a big session. It's gonna be a mega session, which is not always the safest, but we guarantee you like that you're gonna have good results, because I send them pictures of my donor hair, which is quite thick, dark, like very, very coarse hair. They said you most likely you come out with a good result, so I end up going with them, because I didn't really want to go for two procedures. And after I had the operation, I was even more sure that decision I took, I didn't want to go for another session because it was horrible.
Yeah. Oh, really?
People that say the hair transplant don't hurt, they lie, or they get paid from the company, because that's bullshit, man. That's bullshit. That was the worst day of my life, and the worst 3 days after, the worst pain I've ever felt in my life. I would never ever go for another. Even if my hair now don't grow, I'll probably put back hair system again, but I won't go for another surgery. No more.
Oh, interesting. I mean, it's very interesting, because some people do say it's painful, some people say yeah, it's not that bad at all. So I do think that people have different pain tolerances, and I'm not saying that you're a wuss.
But I have a lot of tattoos.
But you might be a wuss. No,
as
joking.
You can see, I mean, I had a lot of tattoos on my arms, here, on my neck.
Yeah, we get it. You're a big, strong man. Yeah, you're not afraid of it.
I'm just saying that. Yeah. I mean, obviously, I'm not scared of needles. I mean, let's just say that. And I can tell you, Jake, trust me, the anesthesia lasted about probably roughly about 10 minutes. That was the worst pain I've ever felt in my life. And it's not just that. I was connected to a machine, like to a heart machine. And I remember, because they injected this anesthesia, and my heart started like, oh my God, so fast. It was going so fast, and my hands started sweating, and I went white. And I thought, I'm going to die on this bed. Because the more I was thinking about the pain, the more I was panicking. So my heart started beating so fast. Oh my God, that was just terrible, man.
I'm not laughing at your pain, it gets a little bit funny in retrospect, you know?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. It makes me laugh. People that say, oh, go for hair transplant, it's nothing, it's like having a little scratch in your head. No, it's not. I mean, the procedure itself, once your head is numb, you don't really feel much, but it's uncomfortable. I mean, people that say, oh, I've slept the whole time, how? I mean, literally, sometimes they ask me to go inside, and I had my face with my nose pressed on the bed. It was just terrible. Just terrible. Absolutely.
Okay. Well, you heard it from Francesco that hair transplants are painful. So there you go. he's not paid by anybody. This video is not sponsored by anybody. Well, that's really interesting feedback, man. So. Now let's kind of wrap up this discussion, because we've been going for near about 20 minutes. It sounds like we've discussed why you've gotten a hair transplant. You know, what are you hoping to get from that procedure? And obviously, this channel at the current moment has mostly people that are interested in hair systems, that are interested in hair loss. But I'm trying to open it up, because I don't want it to be about hair systems. I want it to be about first hair loss, being better men, as like the auxiliary kind of next step after that. So I would like you to describe, you know, what are you hoping happens in this next phase of kind of your journey?
Right. So obviously, I'm going to say this to the older people that are watching. Probably when you get a hair transplant, you're most likely not gonna get your hair as dense as you would like if you was wearing a hair system. Let's start with this. I mean, unless you got enough money to go over 2, 3, maybe even 4 procedures, because let's be honest and let's be realistic. I mean, I know that I'm never gonna have hair as thick as I had when I was wearing a system. That's impossible. I already know that. And even the doctor said to me, said, look, because I showed them the pictures when I was wearing a system. They said, look, I want to be very clear with you. You're going to have a nice hair because you've got loads of grafts in your donor area. You're probably going to have amazing results, but you're not going to get your hair as dense as this. I already knew this, but I was tired of wearing a system of like changing every like 2 or 3 months, because people that say the last 6 months, that's bullshit. I used to change my system every like 7, 8 weeks, sometimes even 10 weeks, because I used to like avoid washing it every day. I used to use a lot of like aftercare. I used to care about my system a lot. And like I said, working in the shop, that helped me. But if people want to get like, they like to change, they want to have so many different styles. For example, one day they want a long, another week they want a short, another week they want a ponytail, then the hair system is great. It's perfect. It looks natural, especially with the last generation hair system, where the base is so thin. And if you manage to cut the front bit like you described in your video the other time, if you can get it right, it looks so natural. So when I actually told my ex-girlfriend, because she didn't know at the beginning, I told her after about 6 months, she couldn't believe it. She thought I was taking a piss. When I said to her I was wearing a hair system, she couldn't believe it. She said to me, shut up, you're lying. She thought it was real. She never, ever thought that was an hair system, ever. Hmm. Unless she was lying, I don't know, but I don't think she would. But.
Who knows?
So yeah, that's it really.
Well, that's good. That's good, man. So, I try to encourage people to do whatever they need to do, whether that's shave their head, get SMP, whatever. Just as a man, take action, do whatever you need to do. So, you know, any parting words of advice for anybody watching this channel, who, you know, whether they want to get any procedure, any solution, you know, what's your advice to them?
My advice is people should go with wherever they feel comfortable with, Jake. That's the thing. If they feel comfortable with going to try the hair transplant, having a hair transplant, they have to also bear in mind that it costs a lot of money. They're not going to see straight away results. I mean, look me, I've had my transplant and the focus has been 2 months and I've lost all my hair because now hair start falling now. As you can see my scalp still a little bit red in front here.
Sure.
And
sure.
You can see my native hair there. You can see my forehead, I've lost all my hair. But it takes a long time to see results. It takes at least 6 to 8 months to start seeing some results. And you need to be prepared to eventually go for a second procedure, because once you started with a hair transplant, it's a lifetime procedure, but you are in between, because you could have great results, but then you could also need another procedure. So if you choose a hair transplant, you need to bear this in mind. But if you want to go with the hair system, it's the easiest way, because it's cheaper. It's very, very, it's very easy to apply, and you can change your style whenever you want. And the best aspect about hair systems, this is what the guy in the clinic told me when I went ahead for the first time. He said, Francesco, the best thing about hair system is that if one day you don't want it, just take it off, wash your hair, shave it, back to normal. It's not commitment, it's not stress, it's stress-free. You can enjoy as long as you want. So if people will feel comfortable with when I give it a go to hair system, then it's fine. Whatever makes them feel comfortable, really.
I love that, man. That's so good. I think there's a lot of pressure that people feel to make the right choice right away. And it's a journey, man.
Yeah. It's just one last thing.
Your proof.
One last thing I would like to say to people to your subscribers.
Sure.
Guys, if you want to have hair system, if you want to try it, don't fear to be judged. Don't worry about other people think. Whatever makes you feel good. If you think that hair loss is a major issue in your life and is affecting your confidence, just go for it. Whatever it is, hair systems, hair transplant, whatever makes you feel comfortable, just go for it. Just do it, because he changed my life for 4 years, and if I allowed to do it again, I would. If the hair transplant don't work, I'd probably go back to it again straight away.
Great. Love it. Well, thank you so much, Francesco, for just telling us your wide story with hair loss and your journey, and showing us that it's iterative and it's okay to change your mind. All of these things. Thank you so much for taking the time out of your day. Everybody, thank you for watching. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell below, and we will see you all soon.